Hey, I feel like watching a YouTube video today. Let's watch the latest Mysterious Mr. Enter video. Oh, oops, the comments are filled with death threats and flame wars. It's come to our attention that being a fan of Jonathan Rosansky or having anything positive to say about him is worthy of being a target for attacks. But why? Is this guy some kind of cyber terrorist or neo-Nazi? Maybe he drowns children in his spare time. No, not even close. He reviews animated content, and he once launched an Indiegogo campaign. Sounds like someone worth making a rant video on. In all seriousness, the whole situation is fairly baffling. For those unfamiliar, while not the start of the criticism, YouTubers like Mars Reviews and Turkey Tom made videos explaining how they felt that Enter painted the review community in a bad light. And they commented on his production value, his review style, and how he tackles morality in cartoons. While they were sometimes factually incorrect or had exaggerated some aspects of Enter, it's safe to say that no one felt that they disliked him as a person, and they are entitled to their opinions. Some channels aren't for you, and that's understandable. However, there have also been videos by YouTubers like Digby the Goat during his collaboration with Just a Robot and Easy Peasy that paint Enter as an SJW, a man-child, and a hateful person. Instead of giving facts or constructive criticism, they behaved as though he filmed a dead body. Instead of picking apart their videos, which would be easy to do, let's just review what Enter's critics normally say about him. Let's get the quick one out of the way. Everyone and their mother knows that Enter is a man-child that exclusively reviews content meant for children. Some of the rated G stuff he's reviewed include King Star King, Family Guy, and The Simpsons. Wait a second, those aren't kid shows. It's almost as if he simply reviews content that's animated regardless of the intended demographic. How strange. But even if he exclusively reviewed kids' content, who cares? Is there a problem with breaking down the story structure of an Ed, and Eddie episode, or discussing the themes of an Avatar, The Last Airbender story arc? No. But by logic of Easy Peasy, Rotten Tomatoes should not be allowed to post reviews of Pixar movies. John simply believes that intelligent writing and storytelling should exist in children's content alongside adult and family content, which isn't unreasonable. It doesn't have to be Shakespeare, but it should be competent, creative, and not teaching your kids to eat paint. Speaking of teaching, it's interesting that there's a common myth that Enter desires that all cartoons have morals. Not only is this hilariously false, but the opposite is true. In his review of the Teen Titans Go episode, Finally a Lesson, he makes multiple statements supporting the idea that he values entertainment over shoehorning morals, especially when said morals are false or poorly made. An understandable criticism he's made was towards the Little Clowns of Happy Town when they had a song that, at one point, encouraged physically disabled kids to dive after drowning people instead of getting a lifeguard. Plus, how do you explain him praising shows that exist without the need for child morals and simply tell stories or jokes if he apparently wants all cartoons to have morals? That's right, you can't, morons. If your argument is that he sometimes reviews Friendship is Magic, you have no platform. There's also the argument that Enter takes cartoons too seriously. I will admit that his earlier reviews seemed to be more difficult to fully interpret. Sometimes you can't tell if he's making a joke or actually frustrated. However, he's made a conscious effort to differentiate to the point where his modern videos have plenty of jokes and self-awareness, something that most critics ignore.
Traitor! How could you do this to your friends?
Chaz is right.
It's kids' time to rule.
So, he believes he's a kid now. So why didn't he apologize or talk to his friends who brought up this possibility to him earlier in the movie? Waiter, I ordered some consistency in this movie. It seems like that you've neglected it completely.
There's nothing wrong with having passion for something, especially something as interesting as the technicalities, the history, and the impact of animation. He's no expert, but I'd like to think that people become professional critics because they were, at some point, passionate. Unless Roger Ebert actually never gave a damn about movies. Again, John isn't a professional, but why fault him for having a fascination for the moving image? Want more evidence that his channel is for passion as opposed to simply an excuse to yell at things? Admirable Animations, a series that most of his critics conveniently ignore because it disproves their narrative of him being a hateful man-child. It was said passion that got him to make the Growing Around Indiegogo campaign. For context, Growing Around is a story universe that Enter has been crafting for years. It's a high-concept narrative about society treats children and teens as the breadwinners and mature demographics, while the adults take the helm as the carefree members of the household. Some people have claimed that Enter made this out of pedophilic desire and stole the idea from Shorty McShortshorts. Both untrue, obviously. The rumor of pedophilia was mostly because someone who read his Growing Around book assumed it was written for such a purpose. As for McShortshorts, no one owns concepts to stories. If someone writes a book about kids finding a portal to a fantasy world with dragons and magic, that doesn't make it a ripoff of Narnia. Back to the campaign. Yes, everyone can admit that it was poorly made. Everyone gets that the goal was high with little time to reach it. Everyone knows that the reward system was flawed. Move on. He didn't make a Kickstarter and run with the money. Commentators like Digby the Goat, Just a Robot, and Turkey Tom seemed to only use the campaign as an excuse to further bash Enter. Was it for views? No idea. What can be confirmed is that none of them actually took the time to constructively judge Enter and his content. Digby and Robot spent 90% of the video bashing John with false claims of diaper fetishism and elitism and simply reacting to the campaign. All in all, nothing of real value. As for Turkey Tom's video, it consisted of, "I don't like Enter's content. He's a pedophile. Why did he hire an editor even though other YouTubers do it too? Why are people giving him the benefit of the doubt instead of attacking him?" Yada, yada, yada. Again, nothing valuable in the slightest. Apparently, according to the valuable resource that is opinions on the internet, John can't take criticism. Never mind that he's constantly viewed as the Chris Chan of the animated review community, and most attempts of him defending himself has caused people to use it as further leverage for bashing. What most people forget that he has apologized for many incidents. One major instance was in his video titled My Top 11 Screw-Ups, which was re-uploaded to Dailymotion due to copyright. If the very existence of a video in which he goes through his errors wasn't enough to convince you of his ability and responsibility to respond to and recognize criticism and personal flaws, take number one on the list. He apologized for overreacting to a review of an episode of Friendship is Magic and for insulting the writers of the episode. Other instances of him owning up to his past mistakes was when he revisited his review of SpongeBob's Pet Sitter Pat. For context, during his review, he displayed his dislike for the writer named Casey Alexander. This caused many of his fans to harass the writer and even make hateful petitions towards him. In John's revisit, he not only apologized on behalf of his fans, but he established to them how he doesn't approve of witch hunting. I know what you're thinking. Enter should be banned for getting a mob to harass someone. Well, that's not true in the slightest. He never said, "Here's Casey's social security number and address. Go get him." Unless Enter did that, he can't be held completely responsible. But the fact that he apologized anyway makes him more respectable than most critics out there. But hey, apparently he can't take criticism. Enter's autism and political leanings are barely mentioned on his channel, unlike what others would claim. According to some, he's an SJW who acts like a triggered college liberal if people disagree with him, even though his review of The Good Family has revealed his more centrist leanings and his belief of the horseshoe theory. He doesn't like SJWs or what they stand for. Want more proof? His Homer Badman review had him reveal his personal belief that the media is often irresponsible and corrupted when discussing and reporting cases of rape or sexual assault, which is not a popular opinion by any means. As for his autism, he only really discusses it as a topic when he criticized Autism Speaks for treating autism as a disease and using paranoia to get parents to fork over money. He doesn't use his autism as a means of garnering pity or excusing any of his actions. End of story. In conclusion, the mysterious Mr. Enter is not perfect, but instead of making cringy MS Paint memes about him, for once in your life, do your own research. Rosansky is just a misunderstood person who tries his hardest to keep his community alive, regardless of the harassment he gets. Enter, if you're watching this, just remember that there are always people who see the bigger picture and know the truth. Don't ever forget that.